Okay, so we're here at EP Jungle. The gym is crazy. I have 9 clients in shows this weekend, so it's going to be an absolute mad one. Checking 3 of the guys this morning. So what we've been doing is literally, as I carb them up, as I dry them out, I'm trying to check them every 2 meals, make sure the peaks are on point. And if you don't know, I've actually relocated back to the UK. I've got a base here in Manchester, so I'm going to be here a lot of the 2024 season, towards the end of the 2023 season, and I'm absolutely buzzing about that. So we have got a crazy day today, tomorrow, with clients. You know, you'll see me kind of like trying to move into my new place, trying to do a million things at once, which is just the way I do things because I'm OCD and I can't not have things done. So really forward to looking at the guys this morning. We started loading a lot of them yesterday. So this is after one day of loading and we started drying them out yesterday. So you're gonna check them out. These guys are looking nuts and I'm fucking buzzing for this show. So let's get it.
Switch my whole life on. I found a way. It was so hard to get what I wanted. I found a way. I had to sacrifice for this life. I found a way. Got sick and tired of wearing the same clothes. I found a way. Got sick and tired of seeing the same holes. I found a way. Drug, any plug, going deck, you can come around the way. I got diamonds on the way, ain't got time for no games. Just wanna shine like a chain. I'm on my mind, I'm from the grind, came to fame. 20,000 in my back pocket, sorry nigga, I ain't got the change.
Niggas just got back from checking clients. So it's 9:20 a.m. I've done my morning routine, which I do every single morning. And I'm just gonna prep my meals for the day now, because today's gonna be a pretty manic day. So I tend to like cook all my carbs the day before. The day before, and then I'll just literally weigh out all my proteins. So basically just gonna prep for a few of my meals now. Probably won't go through them all because it'll take forever. So I'll prep in a few of my meals and then have breakfast and then pretty much head to the gym, train. I'm gonna do back with Troy and Jace. That's gonna be pretty cool. I'm gonna film that for you guys. And then I'll look at clients before that and then yeah, just see how the day goes. My schedule's just insane right now with obviously trying to move back to the UK. So this is actually the Airbnb, this isn't my new place. And I think some really old people have lived in this place because it smells like old people. And it's a like 3-bedroom house. So I've just got this Airbnb till, probably stay till Monday. So my shit's all over the place because obviously I've got to move all my stuff from here into the new place, which I'll kind of show you guys later on. So pre-workout meal is very simple. We've got rice, banana, and chicken breast. I actually use the Bold Standard ready-cooked chicken breast, especially when I'm traveling on the road. Like a lot of guys tell me, oh, how do you stay on prep or how do you stay, you know, on point when you're traveling with all these clients? And the reality is it's doable and it's easy. You just got to be organized. So the great thing about this chicken breast, it's already cooked. So a lot of my food is already cooked, so it's just easy. That's why I do all my protein cooked weight. So literally 175 grams of chicken with this meal. And then my salmon, you know, I buy the pre-cooked salmon usually from Tesco if I'm traveling, or I use a meal prep company that cook it all for me. So it just makes it super easy. So yeah, easiest way to stay on track is just be organized, you know, think ahead. And anyone who makes any excuses about you can't be on track when you're traveling, I just find it bullshit because I travel 24/7 and you know, it's easy to do. Like I said, you just gotta be organized with everything. You know, make your meals in advance, know what you're doing the day before, know what you're doing the day after, and just prep ahead. And it's so, so simple. So this chicken breast worked great. Actually tastes really good. It doesn't go dry or anything, so I like to use this one. Makes life so much easier. Obviously when I'm back in Dubai, I can use raw foods. And like I said, I do have meal prep companies here that I can use. I just kind of prefer that I know, you know, what I'm eating, weigh it all myself. It just makes it super easy. So this is gonna be post-workout meal. Post-workout meal is cream of rice, which is in the freezer, and 175 grams of chicken breast. My protein at the moment's pretty, you know, moderate. It's not crazy high, just kind of right now, just, you know, keeping a good body composition, kind of slightly dieting down a little bit after the operation that I had. just to kind of get my body back to where it needs to be. And then, you know, plan to get a little bit leaner over the next few weeks and then push up into kind of a rebound phase. So yeah, I'm back in training now 6 weeks after my op, and everything's been honestly the best it's ever been since 2016-17. So that's actually nice. I think the rest was very good for me and my body. It was kind of forced rest, not that I wanted to rest, but I think it did my body some good. So gonna prep meals, have me a one, and then show you guys what's for breakfast, and then see how the day goes. So yeah, that's it. Hey, literally, like I said, got back, seen clients. Guys, I'm like 100 miles per hour 24/7. Like, unless people are with me, they don't realize like how much go I am. So like I said, I was up at like 4:45 this morning, went for my walk. I always go for a 30-minute walk in the morning, just clears my head. And then, you know, get back, prep my carbs, either the night before or in the morning. Then I go do my morning routine. I'm not currently doing any cardio at the moment, no direct cardio. Like I said, I'm just going out for a little light walk in the morning. And then I'll go to the gym. I still keep my morning routine the same, so I'll do ab work. I'll do some vacuums, I'll pose, and then I'll hit the sauna, and then I'll shower, and then my day's like ready to go. And obviously after that, we went to see clients. Come back, finish my meal prep, and now we're gonna get meal one in. So meal one is 100 grams of cream of rice, blueberries 150 grams, and salmon. I like to use a lot of salmon in my diet because it digests really well. Sits really nice on my stomach. I find like if I have too much beef, it kind of causes some digestive issues. So I just try to stick with a little bit of beef on a training day. But majority of the time, if I want some higher fatty protein sources, I'll always hit salmon. So I actually have two salmon meals in the morning and night. Bit of pink Himalayan sea salt on that. And if you know me, you know I fucking love ketchup. So ketchup has to go. All of a sudden, I swear I go through a bottle of this like in a day or two, which is probably not the best thing, but it tastes good, so that's all that matters. So I'm gonna eat this, take my morning supplements, which I'll go through quickly, and yeah, start the day. So let's do it. Okay, so my morning supplementation there. I'm huge on health supplements. Anyone who works with me knows that I like put a very, very detailed and extensive health protocol in place. So we have everything in there, like Tudka for the liver, NAC for the liver, bergamot cholesterol, astragalus for the kidneys. You know, we've got the krill oil, the omega-3 for cholesterol. Then I have a big digestive complex in there with a glucose disposal agent, Matador, a ravenous, the digestive enzyme, and a probiotic as well. And then I also take, you know, from Biolabs in the morning, I do a joint and liver support. So that's got glutathione in, and then the B12. So I'll actually shoot that just sub-Q or intramuscular with breakfast. So this is meal one, gonna get meal one in. I have a few client plans to do, so I'm gonna jump on those as well. And then yeah, let's kill today. Gonna get a pre-workout meal in, have a look at everyone at 12:30, and then get my training done and get my shit ticked off. Michael's here already, nice and early. Pre-workout meal, yeah? Yeah, so we're gonna eat some food and then head in to have the clients and then head to kill this back and hamstrings today. So I'm training with Jace and Troy. So Troy's one of my clients. He's won the overall last year. Next year, the aim is to get him pro. And Jace is just Jace, as you guys know. Ex-bodybuilder, but who knows, his comeback maybe soon. Okay, so pre-workout meal going in. Just got 100 grams of raw weight rice, chicken breast, and banana in there, bit of pink Himalayan sea salt. Took one serving of Matador and one serving of Ravenous, which I literally keep in my little pill box here. So that's my digestive enzyme, GDA. I'll take with pretty much every carb meal. And then the good old ketchup is gonna go on there. So we'll get this in, then have a look at some clients. And then in about an hour's time, usually give it about an hour and 15 minutes, we'll train. Okay, so we're back in EP. Gonna have a look at a few clients. So Michael's here, Walter's on his way. Gonna have a look at now for two meals, because what I like to try to do is kind of gauge when they're gonna be on stage, and then I can kind of picture the look, how it may be tomorrow. Obviously it's gonna be better because it's still got a day to fill out and dry out. But it just gives me a little bit more sort of idea of how they look. Now look after them after another two meals. So I'm gonna see Michael now, I'm gonna see Wallace after that. Stefan, I'm going to see him after his train because he's a little bit late, and I'm going to get my own session in between all that.
For this appetite, I need a plate. Green light, no breaks. East coin on my split, put on some Drake. Concentrate on the shit I say. Not enough for night, these names. Fame ain't changed me. Timeless flows, Hollywood nights with no cocaine. Took the train everywhere I went, unless I caught the bus. Look, this rolling. Understand she might get lit, get caught with us.
So we're here in EP. Got hamstrings and back today. You know, I need to kind of put a little bit more tissue on my hamstrings and back. Hopefully you can ever have too much tissue on your back. So yeah, we're going to get in. A crazy session, Troy's training. So he's, Troy's training. Jason's meant to be here, but fuck knows where he is, so we're just gonna get started. Troy's, again, needs to put a bit of tissue on the hamstrings and the back, so it's pretty cool because our split pretty much lines up except leg day because this guy's legs and quads are fucking insane. So he's not allowed to train quads properly. So yeah, we've got some couple of hamstrings movements to start, and then we're gonna head into some back movements after that. And you'll notice like the main focus on my sessions are very, very controlled. I focus on putting as much stress and tension on the muscle as physically possible. You know, we're bodybuilders, we're not fucking powerlifters. We're not just trying to move weight A to B, we're trying to contract and stimulate the muscle. So when you're seeing me doing my reps and perform my reps, you'll notice that, you know, I have a very nice hard contraction in the short range, full range of motion, and almost lengthening it completely, so I'm stretching out the top. So, you know, when you're training, just remember that the end purpose is to build muscle. Strength is a byproduct of muscle gain. It's not the be all and end all. So yeah, I used to train heavier back in the day. Now it's all about refining the physique, you know, making improvements as and when where needed in my physique. So I'm not gonna lift stupid weight and end up, you know, potentially getting injured. I'm gonna be more focused on longevity and the bigger picture. So we're gonna kill this fucking hamstring in the back session, so let's get it done.
Got me peeking through the blinds like Malcolm. 40 on me. Paranoia getting the best of me. I don't want nobody next to me. Don't talk unless you got a check for me. I don't see nobody ahead of me.
Okay, so with the hamstring curl, really trying to put as much stress and tension on the hamstring as possible. So when you see me performing the set, notice I'm not driving it down quick. I'm actually trying to squeeze it down, contract my hamstring as hard as possible in the shorter range for at least 2 seconds, and very slow negative. And notice that I'm actually pausing the stretch and allowing my hamstrings to stretch. And the great thing about the Prime machine is you can actually overstretch your hamstrings at the top. There's a lot of machines that actually restrict your hamstring range of motion. So what I love about this machine is at the top, I can almost pause for 2 seconds, feel a big stretch of my hamstrings, and then I can form the rep again where I'm driving it down. Now the point of this whole exercise is to take the hamstrings to complete failure. And notice that as it gets harder, my reps don't speed up. I stay locked in that type of form and that perfect, immaculate form. Remember, we're bodybuilders. We're trying to put as much stress on the muscle as possible. It's not about moving weight from A to B. It's about contracting and feeling every part of the movement. So, 2 all-out working sets. This is our 3rd working set. I'm actually gonna back off the weight a touch and just go for a slightly higher rep range, because the last set I was failing on about 10 reps. So I wanna stay into that 10 to 15 rep range. So let's kill this next set.
Yeah.
right arm still. Let's go, Jake. Come on. Pull. That's it. Hold it in. Come on. One more. One more, Jake. Five. Let's go. Pull. Pull. Get in. Five.
Don't care if they foreign, we crashing them. Take a look at my bitch, ain't a bad one. Paranoia getting the best of me. I don't want nobody next to me. Don't talk unless you got a check for me. I don't see nobody ahead of me. Foreigns, we jump out the back of them. I cannot wait till this pack is done. Don't care if they foreign, we crashing them. Take a look at my bitch, ain't a bad one. I cannot wait till this pack is done. These niggas fucking the package up. That bullshit they kicking, they
never done. So run up, only in one set. Now, the way my mindset works, they've only got one set. I need to take it to complete failure. So that set is my only opportunity for the week to push it to the limits and take it to the complete maximal effort and to complete level of failure. So I gotta make that set count. So especially after doing three movements or three working sets, my hamstring kill, I gotta make this one RDL movement, you know, count. Because that's my hamstrings done for this session. So now I'm gonna move on to back. So like I said, when you've only got a couple working sets, make sure your mindset's locked in and you're willing to do everything in your power to take that set to the fucking limit. Lock in and go all out.
Hundreds on hundreds, I stack it up. She bust that pussy, then back it up. We standing on couches, we hacking up. I don't think these niggas mad enough. Protect cost me 80, come add it up. Hands in my neck and my face, I got tatted up. I understand why they mad at us. But get out the way when the phantom is backing up. You need to go on vacation and pack it up. Talking about drugs, but these niggas ain't trapping up. Niggas still telling, I guess they ain't rad enough. Came a long way from them dimes in that Acura. So much ice, make them stare. Your wife got caught up in
here. Using the prime roll, we're going single arm, okay? So what we're gonna do, I like to put my feet nice and wide, so I've got a nice stable base. And as I'm doing it, I'm slightly supinating my hand. I'm aiming to drive my elbow in a straight plane of motion and almost get into the lower lat. Okay. One thing that's really important is that you set up the pad so you can get full range of motion. So the whole point of building a back is to fully lengthen the lat and then contract it. So, you know, I want to spend time in the length and range to open my back up, and I also want to spend it in the contraction. So as you notice, I'm not lifting a lot of weight, but notice how I'm performing the exercise. Everything's about squeezing the fuck out of my back, putting it through the full range of motion. So opening the lat up and contracting it, shrinking it down. But very important that you set up the machine right. You know, keep the chest up. Your chest should be fixed on the pad. You shouldn't be rocking back and forth. Nice and wide to get a nice solid base. And really focus on tucking the elbow in, supinated hand, and really contracting that hard.
Fingers getting his bio back. I've not seen a train like this for a little while, you know. I think in a couple of weeks he'll be like, Jay, if you can do a show next year. Innit? Let's see what he says.
Let's go. Rollers for the gang gang. New trucks, yeah, gang bang. Lost some nigga down and hit the lick. 8-6 a nigga for a brick.
Paranoia getting the best of me. I don't want nobody next to me. Don't talk unless you got a check on me. I don't see nobody ahead of me. Foreigns, we jump out the back of them. I cannot wait till this pack is done. Don't care if they foreign, we crashing them. Take a look at my bitch, ain't a bad one. Paranoia getting the best of me. I don't want nobody next to me. Don't talk unless you got a check for me. I don't see nobody ahead of me. Foreigns, we jump out the back of them.
But I cannot wait till this pack is done. Don't care if they foreign, we crashing them. Take a look at my bitch, ain't a bad one. The best of me. I don't want nobody next to me. Don't talk unless you got a check for me. I don't see nobody ahead of me. Foreigns, we jump out the back of them. I cannot wait till this pack is done. Don't care if they foreign, we crashing them. Take a look at my bitch, ain't a bad one. Paranoia getting the best of me. I don't want nobody next to me. Don't talk unless you got a check for me. I don't see nobody ahead of me. Foreigns, we jump out the back of them. I cannot wait till this pack is done. Don't care if they foreign, we crashing them. Take a look at my
whole team. You just want to target the upper back. So notice that we're keeping the chest on the pad and we're trying to roll our lats around the pad as if you're almost going for a lat spread. So I want to fully lengthen the lats and hold it in that stretch position. And as I come up, I want to keep my chest fixed on the pad and contract my back hard. So again, like I was saying, when we're training back, it's about working the back for its full range of motion. So fully lengthening the lats, you know, just holding and pausing there for 2 seconds and then coming up and contracting it. But like I said, just imagine your lats wrapping around the pad. And when you just move it properly, you'll need fuck all weight, but you'll just feel it all in your upper back. Now when your chest starts to come off the pad, you're just working everything. We're trying to focus solely on the upper back.
Till this pack is done. These niggas fucking the package up. That bullshit they kicking ain't adding up. Plus they don't get no pussy like Magic, son. Hundreds on hundreds, I stack it up. She bust that pussy, then back it up. We standing on couches, we acting up. I don't think these niggas mad enough. Protect calls me 80, come add it up. Hands in my neck and my face, I got tatted up. I understand why they mad at us. But get out the way when the Phantom is backing up. You need to go on vacation and pack it up. Talking about drugs, but these niggas ain't trapping up. Niggas still telling, I guess they ain't rad enough. Came a long way from them dimes in that Acura. So much ice, make them stare. Your wife got caught up in the lights like a deer. Living my life, though I know it ain't fair. They think I'm from 12th Street. I run with no fear. See the borough for the live. Yeah. Brown diamonds look like beer. Clear. Shots that hit you, doctor screaming clear. I'm just paranoid. Don't believe in scared. I can see the
day. Okay, so what I've been doing is incorporating basically some isometric holds in the morning with my morning routine and also post-workout. And the whole point is to keep the midsection nice and tight. Whether we're off season, whether in contest prep, I want to focus on make sure I'm vacuuming my stomach in, keep my midsection as tight as possible so that when it transitions to stage, you have quality midsection control. You see a lot of these guys these days, distended stomachs on stage, you know, they can't control the midsection. So what I'm trying to do now is incorporating this at the end of a session when my body's tired, and also in the morning when my body's nice and fresh. So basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to hold an isometric contraction, almost imagine you're holding the mid-range of a sit-up. And as I'm doing it, I'm going to contract my abs as hard as possible, try and vacuum my stomach in, and take real short little breaths to try and keep my midsection nice and tight. So again, it's all going to translate to when we're on stage. So we're going to aim to hold it for a minute. Literally all I do at the moment is do a minute in the morning and a minute at night. And trust me, it's the worst minute of your life. But you can just feel your midsection just get crazy tight.
Paranoia getting the best of me. I don't want nobody next to me. Don't talk unless you got a check on me. I don't see nobody ahead of me. Foreigns, we jump out the back of them. I cannot wait till this pack is done. Don't care if they foreign, we crashing them. Take a look at my bitch, ain't a bad one. Paranoia getting the best.
Trying to open the lats up, keep the shoulders nice and healthy. And as I'm doing this, I'm vacuuming in. So again, it's stomach control. So I'm gonna vacuum in.
I made a million a million times. They must have snorted a million lines. Mind playing trick, Willie D. Let my top down, silly me. Hermes 30 on the hill. Vegas watch, 100 on the strip. Half a 100, hang up hot to cool. Pop that pussy like I'm Uncle Luke.
Post-workout meal. Like I said, even when I'm, you know, looking after clients, you'll see I'm getting my shit done. I don't believe in coaches who are out of shape. I feel like practice what you preach, you know what I mean? I live and breathe this shit. Even if I'm not competing or I'm off season, whatever, I'm still in the gym doing my sessions. I'm still sticking to my meal plan. You know, you gotta live and breathe the life. Like I always say, walk the walk. You know, a lot of coaches these days, they can't be fucked doing it, you know? If you live and breathe it and you love it, then just, you know, do what you love. And I fucking love this shit, so. Post-workout meal, got 175 gram chicken, 125 grams of cream rice with 100 gram of berries. On a back and hamstring day, I do a high day, higher day. And on a leg day, I do a higher day. Then I have a kind of a medium day on my chest day. And then a rest day slightly lower as well. So let's get this meal in. I pretty much sorted in the UK. Just picked up this car today. I didn't want anything stupidly expensive. You know, all I need is a car to get me from A to B that's reliable and can get me to my clients and get me to shows. So we just got a basic like C class. But yeah, so now the car's sorted, the house sorted, I'm back in the UK. I'm fucking buzzing because the gym's sick, you know, so I'm excited about next year and the rest of the year. So I'm gonna head back to the gym, grab our bags, probably head back to the place, chill a little bit, and then go see some more clients later on. Dropping some stuff off, so British finals this weekend, and only I would decide to move into a new place on the same weekend. So I picked up the keys yesterday, got the bed, sofa delivered, the mirror, and then we've got the TV and everything coming, the TV unit, chairs coming on Tuesday, and just literally, that's why there's tons of stuff in the Airbnb, because basically we're gonna move all the stuff over this weekend after the finals. Luckily I got mum and dad that live like an hour away, so they're gonna come tomorrow and help me out because I'm gonna be non-stop with clients, so you know, that's my priority right now. So they're gonna help with that. But yeah, this is the new base in the UK.
Davies talk that talk, streets need that. NYC, LA, Chicago, Detroit, the whole world. Let's get it.
Okay, so after this, pretty much have to go back to EP for the God knows how many time. Have a look at some clients, they're gonna come down because they've all got tans on, obviously they're on stage tomorrow. And then tomorrow morning, I'm basically gonna show you my morning routine, what I do in the morning. And then we're gonna have a look at a few other clients, Troy's in off season who we trained with today. Just kind of, you know, planning out his sort of next phase. So yeah, even though, you know, we've got a busy show this weekend, still gonna look at the other clients who aren't competing this weekend. And just kind of show you my morning routine, you know, show you what I do as a day-to-day routine every single day. And then, yeah, go from there. So we'll catch you in the morning and we'll see you very soon.